Elms Road has always been a quiet kind of place where nothing much ever happened, until now. A developer offered to buy a number of houses in the street. Bill and Shirley Williams didn't want to sell their home for the last 19 years. Then three neighbours moved out and the demolition men moved in. They insist the first official warning they had was a month after the work began, which the developer strenuously denies. He insists it's the Williams who've refused to negotiate. Either way, they find their semi-detached is rapidly becoming detached.
It's very, very traumatic, and I ally this sort of thing to what one would experience in the Blitz during the war, when one can hear all around them rumblings and tremblings and the odd shudder within this property with falling masonry from the other houses, and one begins to wonder, well, is it going to be our wall that's coming down next? We are speaking not only on behalf of ourselves, we're speaking on behalf of any future people that may be put in the position we are now faced with. We hope they never are.
Mr. Williams can't understand why the house had to be knocked down so quickly without giving him and his wife what they consider a reasonable time to think about their own future. They've contacted the local council and their MP, but the demolition is legal, and the developer intends building on the site next year.
I understand how they feel. I understand that people are resistant to change. I think we all are in life. I understand that. It's one of those things, though, that there's got to be progress in this life. I think development is going to happen. And much as we don't want it to happen next door to us, it is going to happen one day, particularly in this situation where you have semi-detached houses with very big, in this case, quarter-acre gardens.
So it all comes down to money?
I think it comes down to money, and I think it comes down also to the need for housing land. If sites like this are not developed in a borough like Harrow, then the only alternative to provide houses for people is to develop in the Green Belt. It's a straight choice.
So, while you need planning permission to build your house, you don't need permission to knock it down. Harrow Council say every time there's been a move to change that law, it's been voted out. And to add insult to injury, the Williams could find their rates going up because they now own a detached property. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.